how to take the dog. You gotta be on a leash. There's also a great fishing spot right there. Last summer I had a guy, I looked on the, he had something big and I looked next to my boat. There was about 100-pound tarpon right next to our boat. And the guy had him hooked up right there. And we came, we watched him for about 15 minutes. And when we came back, had him all hunched over, head down. I think the tarpon was battled. But, that's the south end of Honeymoon Island right there. You gotta try not to. That's the south end of Honeymoon Island, and Honeymoon Island and Kalanisi Island used to only be called Hog Island because they used to raise hogs out here until 1921 when the hurricane hit and created Hurricane Pass, which you're going to see right out here to the right. That was in October 1921. And at that time, then they created Kalanisi Island. And Honeymoon Island stayed Hog Island until 1939. But a developer came around and he said he wanted to build 50 honeymoon cabins out here. So by 1940 they were done and they ran a contest to see who was going to be the first 50 honeymoon couples out here. So they had to send an essay into Life Magazine stating why they deserved to be one of the first 50. So when Life Magazine was vetting all these essays, they came across a couple that had already been married for a while. So they did allow Ronald Reagan and Jane Wyman onto the island. They told them to stay in California and come later. They had to pay. But it didn't last long. 1942, the whole thing kind of collapsed because there was not many honeymoons going on because of World War II. But you can still see, I think they have a honeymoon cabin over at the Interpretive Center over on Honeymoon Island. I've never seen it, but they said it's there. It's not much to look at, but it's there. Now, you know, today is Cinco de Mayo. Now, there's two versions of how Cinco de Mayo got to be Cinco de Mayo. The first version was, there was the Battle of Puebla, when the Mexicans defeated the French Napoleon troops in 1862 on May 5th. It was the battle they sent them for, but they did. So they celebrated it. The other version is, on April 15th, when the Titanic sunk, it sunk with thousands of cases of mayonnaise coming in from England to Mexico. And the Mexicans really treasured their mayonnaise, and it was a delicacy for them. So they were so forlorn, they decided to have kind of a holiday, and they decided it was going to be Cinco de Mayo. Or Cinco de Mayo, whichever one you want to believe is okay.
Clear water,
if you go to 11 o'clock, that's the City of Clearwater meet. Now, if you want to be entertained on a Saturday or Sunday, go down to the end of the causeway to what they call the roundabout. Get yourself a camera and run to the demolition derby. Because it's, a lot of people my age that have never seen a roundabout, and they're trying to figure out what to do. So it's quite entertaining. You ever seen a roundabout? You've never seen one, have you? Yeah. Go with somebody else first. same long, there's never a definitive answer to it. But the first version is there was a guy named Kelly that lived on the island. They named it Kaladesi. The second version is it's a Native American word that means sacred bayou. The third version, which is the one I like, there's a Spanish sea captain that came here in the 1500s. He came into the bayou here and he had an Italian sailor on board. Then he was looking at here, he says, oh, this is a beautiful bayou. And the guy says, well, the Kaladesi was called a Kaladesi. That's the version. So pick it up. I think that's a little more romantic. Number three, I like that.
Every half hour. Your return time is 4:30.